Researchers involved in a taxpayer-funded study about how the invasion of green crabs has affected clamming in the Freeport area admit there are some problems with the study's results. Fenced placed on river flats fell apart, and the study's author says that makes some of the data weak at best. WMTW News 8's Paul Merrill joins us now live from Freeport to explain. Paul?
There are about 50 clammers who work these waters for a living, and Freeport Town officials thought it would be worth the money to invest in the study to see the effects of the green crab species on the soft shell clam species here. And the results of that study are just now coming in, and there are some problems with the data. Green crabs have been putting mid-coast clammers in a pinch.
When the clams spawn out in the summertime, when that spawn settles down the mud to start to grow, there's so many crabs scurrying around that they eat all the spawn, so there's no little ones left to grow to spawn for the next few years.
Clint Goodnow and other clammers helped out with last year's study of the effects green crabs are having on the soft-shell clam population here in the Harriseket River. The study, conducted by University of Maine Ecology Professor Brian Beal, focused on three flats. Beal, clammers, and workers from a Brunswick consulting company set up fencing to isolate areas. But in many places, the fencing failed, meaning some of the data was not reliable.
We learned a lot. I mean, maybe it wasn't done right last year, and things got kind of pushed up with permitting issues and everything else, and then it got all rushed in. And it was probably too late to put it out when we did, but we still tried to get it out and see what would happen.
Goodnow and Beal say the results of the study confirm what clammers have been saying for years, that green crabs are having a predatory effect on the soft-shell clam population here.
We did get some information out of the study, so it's not like it was a completely, you know, blown study, but there were some parts of it, obviously, that didn't turn out the way that the council had hoped that they would, I don't think.
Peter Joseph is Freeport's town manager. He says there was a lot of finger-pointing when the initial results of the study were first presented to the town council.
It's kind of a little bit of a muddy situation there.
Joseph estimates that last summer's study cost taxpayers between $30,000 and $50,000. We asked Clint Goodnow why people in the clamming industry aren't the ones paying for this research.
Taxpayers fund almost everything in this country at some level to get things going and fix things.
The town does budget about 50 grand every year to look at the issue of the green crabs and the effects they have on the water and the species here. Dr. Beal has a $200,000 grant coming up from the university, so he told me by phone this afternoon that this summer he gets the rare chance for a do-over. Live in Freeport, Paul Merrill, WMTW News 8.